Hello guys, welcome back. It's your girl yemi.com. Thank you for watching, my internet friends. Thank you for liking, subscribing, and overall vibing. We love that you're here. Today we're doing something a little more girl power-y, girl in the line of female empowerment of young girls. I grew up on a lot of cartoons. You probably can tell because of my overall sunny disposition and sometimes how I talk, like I'm in a cartoon. But I grew up on a lot of cartoons, but one of the things that I did love about the cartoons, of course I watched, you know, a lot of boyish stuff, but I did watch a lot of girly stuff. So I'm here to talk to you, or at least give you a list of cartoons if you haven't seen them, that are very female forward. Both cartoon groups, like groups or collective of women, or characters individually. I will first go through the groups and then I'll go through the individual characters. We have 6 groups, 4 characters, 10 total. First, we're gonna start off with the girls that are on my chest, and that is the ladies of Sailor Moon, baby. I grew up watching dubbed versions of Sailor Moon because we didn't have Hulu back then where we can watch subs, and like even now I watch the dubbed versions of Sailor Moon because I grew up watching the dubbed version, and anything else just sounds insane to me. I don't know why. For anything else, in every other situation, I am subs over dubs. But for some reason, when we're talking about our childhood things that we watched as dubbed, I cannot see them as anything else. The girls on my chest, for you who you don't know, are the girls of the Sailor crew. There's Sailor Moon, where we start, Usagi.
In the name of the moon, I, Sailor Moon, will punish you!
And then it branches off to all of the different planets and realms.
If I'm Mercury, planet of water, guardian of wisdom, I am Sailor Mercury, protected by Mars.
By Jupiter, the planet of thunder, guardian of protection. I am Sailor Jupiter.
Protected by Venus, the planet of youth, guardian of love. I am Sailor Venus.
Protected by Uranus, the planet of the sky, the guardian of flight. Sailor Uranus.
Protected by Neptune, planet of the deep blue sea.
Protected by Pluto, the planet of space and time, the guardian of revolution, Sailor Pluto! Protected by Saturn, the planet of silence, the guardian of ruin and birth, Sailor Saturn!
This is it. This is feminism. We've won.
You know, we have moon princesses. We have Tuxedo Mask. Oh, but we're not talking about him today because this is a girl show. We're girls, right? Anyways, so I wanted to kind of introduce those who don't know what rock were you living under, but also those who do know, remind you of how great and excellent all of these girls were. My favorite was always Sailor Jupiter.
Her name's Makoto Kino, and the word is that she's incredibly strong.
And Sailor Mars, they were both really dope, and I think that they were just the first harem of girls. That's a terrible word. First group of girls that were like, yes, it was a love story. Yes, there was love involved. Yes, there were all these other plots moving, but that were just generally like the Power Rangers, but for girls. Like, I did watch Power Rangers, even though they were for boys, but they were like the super powered, cool girls who still had to go to school just like me, who were imbued by these powers from this far off land. And it just goes on and on and on. And I've rewatched that cartoon probably more than any other cartoon that I had from my childhood. I think the only cartoon that beats it that I've rewatched is Class of 3000. But outside of that, it's Sailor Moon, baby. Next up is Winx. Winx Club was a group of just fairies. They were fairies or princesses. I honestly can't tell what they were. I can't tell you because I feel like they were princesses, but they were princesses with magical powers and they were built to defend their kingdoms. It was weird. It all started with one girl named Bloom.
Close your eyes and open your heart. Believe in yourself. That's how it starts.
And then, of course, she went to this school that was full of other girls with magical powers. And then she found her crew that consisted of Musa, who was my favorite, Tecna, Stella, who was kind of a bitch, if we're being honest, and the rest of the girls. Like, obviously, we have Flora, the list keeps going on. They had a school that was like across the way that was for boys who didn't have superpowers, but just like did flips. And I was like, that's how boys should be, ornamental. Siri, play Just a Ken.
I'm just Ken, where I see the love she sees a friend.
I like a dumb
I know,
man.
It's so sweet.
I like dumb men.
Men, stay dumb.
Stay dumb,
men. You don't need to be smart. You really don't
need to be smart. And also, you don't need to do any, like, you don't, just
you
be.
Don't need, just, yeah. You just don't need to do
dumb.
Anything. Yeah.
Your job is beach.
Your job is beach.
But with all that being said, it was kind of inspirational to watch because, yes, with Sailor Moon, they all had superpowers and they were all born into this situation of craziness. And so was the Winx Club. It was like just that, but with wings. And like that was cool as hell to me because it was like, oh, so it's like superpowers and they can fly? Cool. I love that. I love that energy. Absolutely. We're rocking with this. We're rolling with this. So that was kind of the Winx Club for me. On top of the Winx Club, I watched congruently a show, which is our next show, which is Witch. Witch. W-I-T-C-H. Which kind of inspired the theme song of this video, which is rumor on the street is that apple ships. But her exes say she's wicked. She's a woman in total control of herself.
Will Irma, Tarani, Cornelia, Halen. You have been chosen as the new Guardians of the Veil.
Ooh! And look what I figured out, our initial spell!
The main thing is, the bad guy didn't get our new best friend.
Yeah, so that kind of inspired it, but it was an actual show. A lot of people don't remember this show, which boggles my mind because I was obsessed with it. So obsessed that I made my mother drive me to Books A Million so that I could buy a copy of the comic. And I literally was like, I know what's gonna happen. I read it in the comic. And it was basically, again, a similar group of girls with superpowers unbeknownst to themselves. They all, for some reason, were given elemental powers. Tara's always been my, like, costume. Terrence.
Tarani?
She has glasses and blue hair and, like, has the pigtails that go everywhere.
Man, I hate heights. I get woozy in high-heeled shoes.
That's my dream Halloween costume. I've never been able to successfully pull it off, but I will one day. The title, Witch, is all spelled from letters of their names. Our main character is Will. She's a redhead with a sparky personality, which I guess now that I say that it is similar to Winx. And they do fly just like in Winx. Huh. Anyways, and they do have elemental powers just like I don't think music's an elemental power, never mind.
Hate to disappoint you, but I can't even do that trick where it looks like your thumb comes apart. But if I ever have a party, you guys are definitely the entertainment.
And they were forced to get into this battle of evil, trying to keep the real world and the realm, fairy, fae, whatever realm, at bay. It's similar to a lot of girls on this list, but it was just so real. Like, this one felt so much more grounded in reality than any of the others, and I think it's because it rarely ever took place in anything but reality. With Winx, of course, they were in a far-off land. Sometimes they would go to reality, but for the most part, they were in a far-off land. With Sailor Moon, they were in a real world, but they were moon princesses. So far removed from anything. These were just normal girls who didn't have any false lineage dialing back to ages ago. Not false, but like lineage dialing back to years ago in which they've forgotten their royal powers. No, they were just girls who were imbued with powers and were bad bitches because of it. Another group of girls who didn't like each other, and that is Mew Mew Power. I used to mix up Mew Mew Power and Sailor Moon so much, and that is a cardinal sin that I will carry to my grave. I should not have rights, I should not have done that. But I really did used to mix these shows up because I watched them both so frequently. I would blend plot points to the point that it was just wild in general. Mew Mew Power was all about a girl who had powers imbued from different endangered species. So they each had like an endangered species kind of as their wing woman, I guess you would say, as their spirit animal.
Like a spirit animal!
But they all had powers imbued to them by their spirit animals, and they infused their DNA, unbeknownst to themselves, with animals. And it was just two men making these decisions, who were like toddlers, like they were college students, I think, with wild science skills. Regardless of that being said, it was all fun and jokes until her crush kept getting in trouble with these giant monsters.
For you.
Oh. Ah! Elliot, it's gorgeous!
I thought you'd like it. It's your favorite color.
What's the matter?
Stay still. That's better.
Listen, I know a lot of people have a lot of things to say about this age difference, but it's actually not that different from Mamoru and Usagi. Also, they give me the same vibe as Mamoru and Usagi with the arguing and the bickering and the back and forth. Both of them are middle schoolers dating high schoolers, or in Mamoru's case, a college student who is 17. They would fuse monsters with real world objects and then just have to fight them. And then there was something would come and eat the little ghost spirit that comes from it into the netherworld. It was actually a wild show now that I'm thinking about it. How did I watch that? Wild. Anyway, they were bad bitches.
Mew Mew style, Mew Mew grace, Mew Mew power in your face.
Don't know why, but that stuck to me. Much like the rap from Lemonade Mouth. Don't know why. Next up we have three sisters. Obviously they're sisters. There's three of them. We're talking about the Powerpuff Girls, baby.
Blossom, Bubbles, and Buttercup have dedicated their lives to fighting crime and the forces of evil.
The Powerpuff Girls were seminal classic. They were the ones that ruled the Cartoon Network for a really long time for me. They were an amazing trio of Blossom, Bubbles, and Buttercup, all formed by the Chemical X and Professor Utonium's negligence? I don't know. They were superheroes, straight up, no doubt about it. They were also in kindergarten perpetually. They really did embody the word sugar, spice, and everything nice, because Bubbles was sugar, Buttercup was spice, And Blossom was just nice. Like, they shaped so many young girls. Even now to this day, New Jeans is doing their concept around the whole thought of the Powerpuff Girls. Look, it's a new me, switched it up, new space, booty bump, new jeans, so fresh, so clean. That just shows how classic and effervescent and spanning decades they are. They will never grow up, and they will always live in our hearts. Puppy dogs, kitty cats, swimming in the love, 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 makes the world go round. Next up, we have another trio that is a little bit less talked about, but it was also on the Cartoon Network, and I am talking about Totally Spies. This is another cartoon I love so much that I went to go get the graphic novel of the episodes. So, like, with Witch, it was like the graphic novels existed and then that you can get the you could watch the episodes and know what was going on. No, with Totally Spies, it was literally, they just took the screen panels from the episode and put them with, like, bubbles, like, that you could write with, like, that they wrote into. Like, it's literally one for one, just episodes in book form. And I was like, I read. I loved Totally Spies. I always saw myself as a Sam or a Clover. Not that no one wanted to be, what's her name? Alex? But I always thought I was like a Sam or a Clover. Let's be real, Clover, cause I'm a little bit dumb and like boys a little bit too much.
Clover, what is it? What's wrong? Yeah, what's with all the drool?
I think I'm in love.
But they kind of again embodied the like trio of things. You could be sporty Spice, like Alex. You could be like Sam and be an intellectual, or you could be a dumb girl who likes hot guys like Clover, like me. There was just so much to like unpack in their personalities. They were also one of the first cartoons to do this, and I really, really did love it. They were one of the first cartoons to like change the outfits. Like, it was probably costly, but really cool, and I really liked it.
Guys, are you noticing what I'm noticing?
That our outfits are radiating with impeccable taste?
They had gadgets, and unlike every other girl on this like list, they didn't have magical powers. They were just badass spies. They were cutthroat, deep in the nitty-gritty spy game. And they were also just super amazing. And I also love that all of their gadgets that they had were just like seminal classic girly things, like a hairdryer or a compact.
And what are we waiting for? Bring on the gadgets.
Very well then. First, we have your new compounders. Now with DNA recognition. Hands-free capabilities, which literally allow the devices to float beside you if you happen to be tied up by a villain, multiple data window projection function, and a shiny skin detector.
You mean like for detecting a slimy bad guy with creepy tentacles or something?
No, for detecting when your faces get extra sweaty on mission. In the unfortunate event of breakthrough shine, the compounder will beep, alerting you that it's time to apply a fresh coat of powder.
Awesome!
It was very much in the vein of girl power. So the blah 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 sporty face, scary face, which goes blah 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 girl power,
blah 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 girl power, feminism. Do you know what I mean?
Very much in that vein. Now that we've touched on our groups, we're gonna hit our four individuals real quick, just rapid fire then. Of course, first we have to, there's no list that is complete about girl power without Mulan.
I brought you the Sword of Shan Yu and the Crest of the Emperor. They're gifts to honor the Fa family.
The greatest gift and honor is having you for a daughter.
Mulan was the Disney princess to dress up like a man and be a woman and save a nation. Did she need a man? No. Did she get one? Yes.
Great. She brings home a sword. If you ask me, she should have brought home a man.
Excuse me. Does Fa Mulan live here?
I don't know. You know, maybe if you saved a nation, you would find a good man too. Ever think of that? But despite all of that, she really was this embodiment of honor and family that was just so complex thoughts as a child, but like really made it digestible. And the songs were bangers, dude. You can never deny. I'll Make a Man Out of You is still one of the best Disney songs, no matter what that Rolling Stones article says, to this day. On the opposite end, we support women's rights and women's wrongs. So we are also going to talk about Shego.
This is your army of youth? I think you missed by about 50 years, Doug.
She was also a Disney character, but she was a Disney TV show character. She was on Kim Possible. Obviously, Kim Possible stands for her own right and moral righteousness of girl power, but there was something about Shego just choosing to make the bad decision. She was working for a man who was well underpaying her probably, and so stupid she could do the job herself, but she was like, I'm just here for my check to clear. Like,
set the mainsail, wench.
Okay, first of all, we don't have any sails. Second of all, call me wench again and we'll be planning a burial at sea.
It was really giving, like, I just want my diamonds, I don't know why I'm here. And I love that energy. Again, we support women's rights and women's wrongs. And I love, and Shego, let's be real. Between Kim Possible and Shego, which one would you rather be?
You may be a cranky smart mouth prone to excessive violence, but deep down, you are still a member of Team Go, a hero.
Higo, I quit your stupid team years ago, and after I quit, I went to work for a guy who wants to take over the world.
It's true.
Let's be real, Shego, because A, she had superpowers, and B, she was just so snarky. She was so smart. Like, a lot of the times, again, when you're seeing these characters, you see them be snarky, like Buttercup a little bit. You see them be smart and less snark. But Shego was snark, and I love that about her.
Are you saying that I am going soft?
As a marshmallow.
Shego, I take it back. You're not a softie.
Our next one, before our last one, is Rogue. I surprisingly watched a lot of boy TV, which was like X-Men and Power Rangers and stuff like that. And I watched X-Men and I loved Rogue. I thought Rogue was the best. Again, it's another Halloween costume I've never been able to execute, but mark my words, I will. I love Rogue. She was one of my favorite characters to exist to date. She was the best X-Men because, in her words,
my power is your power and I can take more than one.
She was Southern, which if you've seen my accent video, you know I love Southern people. She was interesting, depth, dynamic, tortured, a bad guy, a good guy, just a person trying to figure themselves out in this world. And she really exemplified that. And genuinely had, other than like Jean Grey and Professor X, the strongest power. She could take other people's power to the point where you no longer have that power, buddy. It's hers now. And she can take more than one. That is an insane feat to me, and how anyone supports anyone but Rogue and possibly Jean Grey, but mostly Rogue, is wild. I would never want to go up against her in battle. She's just a classic, seminal, bad bitch. And for our last person, we are staying in the vein of all-powerful superwomen, and we are reaching out across back to Cartoon Network to talk to Raven.
Told you we'd win you a prize.
A giant chicken. I must be the luckiest girl in the world.
Not the Teen Titans Go Raven, but the regular Teen Titans Raven. Again, watched a lot of cartoons, and Teen Titans was one of my favorite shows ever. Again, Raven is a Halloween costume I have not yet to pull off. But she was one of my favorite characters. She was a tortured, misunderstood. She was the first official weird girl that our generation of millennials really like vibed and clicked to. Like, she was around when I was like just entering the infancies of my edgy dark girl phase, like where I would be in middle school changing my bangs up every day to match my mood. You know what I mean? Like, she really like kind of spearheaded that. And on top of all of that, she had active daddy issues, and I respect anyone who airs their dirty laundry out on Cartoon Network.
Father's raised you.
I was protected by the monks of Azeroth. I was raised by my friends.
As well as unlimited powers. Her powers were kind of like just dark magic, really. Like, yeah, Starfire is an alien, and Robin is Batman's son, child, protege. But she was the daughter of the devil. Like, she was literally the daughter of a demon, and that's where she got her mystical powers from. And if you tell me that the phrase Azeroth, Netrion, Synthos does not ring a primal memory in your brain, you're lying to yourself. There's no way you're of my generation. You're lying to yourself, because she was one of the original, like, killers. Like, I still remember the episode, which was, like, her episode with her dad, and there was, like, the different ravens in her brain. And she got in the all white long haired raven look, and she was like, I'm finally gonna kill everyone. Like, her whole body was like ripped, her outfit was ripped up, her hair was long. She murked her dad, man. It was great. With that being said, she is our final killer on the list, our final cartoon character that is a woman that is also a badass and also amazing. I highly recommend you check out all these cartoons so that I'm not thinking that this was a fever dream. With that being said, I'm yummy.com. Thank you for joining me, internet friends. Don't worry, I'll be back and stay tuned.